So if you go back to the beginning of the year, we had generally been quite concerned about rising interest rates, and that has played out. So we've seen a pretty sizable increase in interest rates, particularly in the short to intermediate part of the yield curve. The market is priced in continued increase in the Fed funds rate. Despite that, we actually continue to be more concerned about future interest rate increases. We do think that the Fed has gone from wanting monetary policy to be very easy to wanting it to be less easy. So we want them to see tighter financial conditions, and that means they're probably going to continue on a quarterly pace to raise the Fed funds rate, and we think that will continue into next year. So our portfolio position right now is to continue to be a little bit shorter than our benchmarks. And focusing predominantly on the belly of the curve, so think the 5 to 7 year maturities. We do think that the curve could see some steepening, but probably not that much given that the Fed is in play and is raising interest rates. When we think about the credit markets, we have had a relatively positive view, but more conservative. So our portfolio positioning is to take advantage of some incremental spread, but to be pretty conservative about how we are positioned in those markets. So if you go back again to beginning of the year, credit spreads were very tight. Our economic view and our fundamental view on corporate performance is actually quite positive, but you have to think about two things. One is valuation, which tend to be quite tight, particularly going back a few months. And then secondly, we do think while the economy is doing well right now, if the Fed is tightening financial conditions, eventually we will go into recession, and that could be 1, 2, or maybe even 3 years out, but the market does tend to price that in advance. So we are still concerned about both valuations and fundamentals in the credit market, so we're cautiously optimistic, positioning portfolios to be slightly overweight credit risk. With the recent widening in credit spreads, we've seen that as an opportunity to add a bit, particularly in the investment grade credit market, and particularly in the short to intermediate term maturities.